do's and don'ts of journalism. We'll be looking at an up-and-coming journalist and his rise into stardom. With the help of these books, the journey will be easy, but there will be challenges along the way. So let's get into it.
I just saw in an article from my old high school's Playboy magazine that Charlie D'Amelio and the Gary V had a one-night stand.
Sweet, all set, and...
Wait a second. Before you go any further, take a look at chapter 3 of this book right there. It'll tell you exactly what to do about social media.
Thanks, Mr. Announcer Man.
Like War is a modern take on the world of journalism. It covers issues from ISIS to memes about Pepe the Frog. Throughout the book, however, social media was always at the center. The authors ensured that we the people knew not only the good side of social media, but the bad side as well. From a journalistic standpoint, during Chapter 3, they focused on the idea of fake news and its rise due to social media.
It was confirmed to be Logan Paul and not Gary V.
There you go, Bucko. Now you're getting the hang of it.
Gosh darn it, Flavitt. I freaking hate Trump and all of his ideals. He makes me so mad. I'm gonna write such a strongly worded article about him.
Whoa there, before you type anything, why don't you look up Just the Facts by David Mindich. He'll tell you all you need to know about detachment.
In David Mindich's book, Just the Facts, he breaks down the five elements of journalistic objectivity. Nonpartisanship is when you do not affiliate yourself with a political party or a certain side of the story. The inverted pyramid is starting an article with the key points right away to engage the reader or to ensure they read it if they do not have time. Balance is being able to include both sides of the story, no matter how wrong or right one side may be. Facticity is, well, writing the article with all the facts, regardless of if you agree with them or not, because people deserve the facts. And then, detachment. The ability to remove yourself from an article or piece so that it is focused around the subject and not you. Use these five elements and you'll be a great journalist.
Trump so much, but I can't let my freaking feelings get in the way of this gosh dang article. I have to give the people the facts and nothing but the facts. I can't do any of the biased stuff. It's hard. Today we're here with a young politician. So, Hannah, what are your thoughts about Trump?
I think Trump's an idiot, but the even bigger idiot is you.
You son of a- Take a chill pill there, pal. If Katie Turner can get through what she did, then so can you.
Katie Turr's Unbelievable covered her journey through one of the craziest campaigns in U.S. history. Her problem was that even though she did focus on Trump, her ideals weren't exactly the same as what he supported. The whole steak debacle was Turr somewhat mocking Trump, saying that he was more businessman than politician. Trump didn't retaliate, however, attacking Turr on a few occasions. But she did not let that stop her, and still did one of the best reporting jobs of that campaign.
Today we're here with a young politician. So, Hannah, what are your ideals about
I think Trump is an idiot, but you're the even bigger idiot.
That was rude, but I'm not going to get angry, because I respect you.
So, at the end of the day, our young protege has risen in the ranks of journalism. Remember, as long as you fact-check, stay detached, and remain calm and collected, you can be a great journalist like young Anthony over there. Until next time, kids. Bye-bye! These books. Joe, close it a little harder.
What?